So, as promised, the first startup is Conio. So, here it's with us Vincenzo Di Nicola, co-CEO and co-founder of Conio. Thanks, Vincenzo, to be with us.
No, thanks for the invitation. First of all, thanks for being here. I have a terrible accent and I'm even a worse presenter, so please, I hope you know you don't get bored and be kind with your valuation at the end. Question for you, how comfortable you feel about the stability of our current financial system? Are you happy? You think everything's good, everything's fine? I feel like people are a little skeptical. Well, I don't know you, but I keep hearing about defaults. Greece, it's next door, it's not in good shape. Monte dei Paschi, the third largest bank in Italy, got saved by the government with 20 billion euros. I mean, and furthermore, you don't see an end to these sort of events. I'm a little worried. I keep hearing about the stories, I don't see a path to progression, and also, more importantly, I know that there could be a moment when funds that are mine in the bank can be locked and I cannot be accessible to me anymore. So things that I believe are mine are no longer mine. So maybe a little bit paranoid, but again, this is something that I feel everybody should start considering. At the same time, in the past 8 years, something has happened. There has been something called, there is a new technical evolution has emerged in the form of virtual currency. I'm not sure how many of you have heard of Bitcoin, have played with it, have purchased it, have used it. Anyone in the audience? Only one person out of how many? Around here, 50? So, what is Bitcoin? Bitcoin is a private currency, something that is still in its early stage. I mean, it's 8 years old, and allows people to be more in control of their funds. So it's very, it's not easy to explain in a few sentences, especially here in a very small meetup like this. However, you can see it as money that you have on your pocket and you control, that nobody can steal it away from you, and you manage, and can you do whatever you want with it. Our goal in Conio is to bring virtual currencies to the mass market, so that everybody who has heard of Bitcoin, who wants to purchase it, who wants to touch it, who wants to use it, can do it. Nowadays, it's too confined to a very small niche of people. We want to bring it to a much, much larger market, and that's our goal. So we have a solution that we believe is simple, safe, and compliant. Simple because, I mean, I cannot show you the app right now, but we're going to launch it very soon in the coming month. But as you can see from the screenshot on our website, we want to give physicity to the virtual currency. When you hear about virtual currency, one of the first things that people say, it's virtual money, it's monopoly, it's like some sort of fake money, something that doesn't exist. Well, we want to show you that something that's in your phone that makes noise, that actually you can touch it. You can almost feel it's like gold in your pocket. Second, we want to show you that you're always in full control of it. I mean, let's say that you want to use it, nobody's going to stop you from doing it. Let's say you want to move it somewhere else, you're free to do whatever you want. And also we have a solution that allows you to, in case you lose your wallet, because for many reasons, you can lose your phone, you can forget it, you can destroy it. We have a solution that allows you to recover those funds at the same time. Third, we worked with the Italian Fiscal Agency, and we got an Interpel, which is a fiscal pronunciation, tax ruling pronunciation, that says that if you have Bitcoin and you use for non-speculative reasons, that's tax-free, which is that you buy Bitcoin today and maybe you keep it. You want to see what happens, and let's say tomorrow, like next year, you sell it, there's not going to be any tax on your capital gain. So that's actually something very good that's actually bringing Italy on a very advanced position in this space. So, can I say? Our app is going to be ready like this coming month. If you want to subscribe to the beta, please do it. It's going to be just the beginning, because something that people don't realize about Bitcoin is just like the tip of the iceberg. Behind the scene, there is this thing called blockchain, which is the technology that runs Bitcoin, that can be used for things other than the currency itself. So we're also working with institutions to do proof of concepts on timestamping for notarization. We're working on other proof of concept for certification on mails and delivery, and also for trades. Let's say that you want to prove that you've done a trade at certain point in time, you can do it on the blockchain, because it's something you can see it as a registry, large distributed database, not controlled by anybody, that, however, certifies that you've done an action at certain point in time, and everybody can consult it. So right now, we don't, talking about this meetup, we don't make big use of big data right now, because we just started. Moving forward in the future, we see interesting application for big data and data science in our solutions, because let's say that 5 years from today, you want to attach an asset to the blockchain. You can move stocks, you can move physical money. I mean, at that point, the number of data that you want to analyze is going to be much, much larger than today. And I think that solution, I don't know, like KX or Redshift or others, could be valuable to us. But if you have questions, please let me know.
So you've got 9 minutes.
Yeah,
so plenty of time.
Questions? I left everybody speechless.
Are you worried at all about the rise and fall of Bitcoin and sort of what's got out in the markets over the past 8 years since it's been into existence?
But I mean, if you look at it right now, Bitcoin is at its peak. Right now, it's like worth one Bitcoin, $1,400. I mean, that's as of this morning. So I mean, as everything that it's new, like I said, it's like only 8 year old. Something that's compared to the, I mean, even internet is not that, it's not been there forever. So it's something relatively new, and it has its up and downs. But if you look at Bitcoin's price, which is a metric, I mean, I don't think it's like the most important metric, but again, I understand that people want to see it. I mean, you see that there's been a peak in end of 2013, beginning of 2014, and then it went down. And then it started picking up gradually, growing, I mean, from on steadily. I mean, steadily growing in much, much organic growth. What I see also at the same time is a more professional player in the space. Like at the very beginning, you might see people with no computer science skill set coming to this game. I mean, somebody might have heard of MTGOX, which was this major website that collapsed at the end of 2013, which was handling 80% of transactions in Bitcoin. That website, I mean, is called MTGOX because it stands for Magic the Gathering Online Exchange, which means that they were selling Magic cards. I don't know if, I mean, you play Magic, but you don't, okay, the same person, but interesting. But that was a website, and I'm sure you were also a customer at this point. Okay. That was a website that was selling cards, card games, which they're great, wonderful. Yu-Gi-Oh, Pokémon, great. But then it was also selling Bitcoin. I mean, you can understand that the technology sophistication of people in that website was not that great. Now there are players that are way, way more sophisticated, way more professional, so much very positive. One thing that I'm a little concerned is actually is more not Bitcoin per se, because I know that virtual currencies are gonna take off. I mean, 5 years, 10 years, I mean, you're gonna keep hearing more and more about virtual currencies. The question is if it's gonna be Bitcoin or something else. That I don't know, but I mean, you're gonna see some big news in the coming years.
And countries' regulations against this, I know you mentioned it, but other countries that are.
But each, no, that's a good question. I mean, each country is a different. I mean, Bitcoin as a currency, it's a worldwide currency. However, we live in a real world, and I mean, each country, you know, that has its own different laws. I mean, United States, for example, has a terrible regulation for, I mean, it's everything is legal, it's a private currency. In a free country, you can do whatever you want. I mean, if you want to buy a car with gummy bears, and the dealer accepts gummy bears, I mean, everything is okay. So there is no problem with it. The problem is actually more about taxation, if how you deal gains in Bitcoin. And United States has a terrible regulation on that side, on the point of view. Italy has a wonderful regulation. People talk about bad about it for many things, not in this case. Other countries have their own set of regulations, so I understand that it's a problem, but it's not the biggest of a problem. I mean, you just start and then eventually you move and you solve these issues.
I have one question.
How many Bitcoins do we have in Italy then? Circulating, and this is the first, and the second is what can you generally buy? You have Bitcoins, how do you spend those Bitcoins?
Okay.
Generally?
No, I mean, I don't know how many Bitcoins are in Italy. I mean, I never done analysis. Right now, I don't think that many. Usually, virtual currencies, not just Bitcoin, but Ethereum, other currencies, they are mostly used in China, and I can tell you also in Silicon Valley. I mean, every day I open my news feed in Facebook, and I mean, because I lived in Silicon Valley for 10 years, I can tell you that every day I see people looking to buy and sell Bitcoin. It's actually exploding over there. In Italy, we're still like in a very, very early stage, so I don't think really that many. To answer the other question, I mean, how can I spend it? And like a week ago, I spent it to buy a video game. I mean, like, I don't know how many of you have played adventure games. I spent $19 in Bitcoin on Steam, which is like a portal for buying video games. And I mean, great video game, but now those $20 now, I mean, they were worth 30. So I don't think I did a very good deal. But there are plenty of ways you can do it. I mean, what we discover is that people, from a personal point of view, again, everybody's different, so I cannot tell you that everybody's going to prefer to, let's say, you buy $1,000 in Bitcoin, and then that €1,000 become $1,500. What we notice is that people spend those €500 of theoretical capital gain, they spend it for travel, and in fact, Expedia actually accepts Bitcoin in the US. Or they spend for clothes, like for shoes, I mean, especially if you have a girlfriend or a wife. I mean, that's what we noticed actually is very common. And right now you don't see it too often because not the people have Bitcoin, other virtual currencies, but I mean, this is what we noticed, that once they have it, that's what they do.
Is it common that Bitcoins are used for criminal purposes?
I mean, everything is, I mean, you can do, even with cash, I mean, you can use cash for criminal purposes as well. I mean,
do you know more or less what percentage of the transactions
I don't know. I mean, to be honest, I mean, it would be, I mean, whatever number I would give you, I mean, I had it on the top of my mind, but I don't have the recent numbers. At the same time, it's not that what I want to say is that the technology per se is not evil, is not bad. I mean, technology is agnostic. Is the use that you have, that you do with technology, that it may be illegal or maybe not moral. I mean, we look a lot here. I mean, some of this light comes from nuclear power, even if Italy is not is a nuclear, anti-nuclear country. Some of this light comes, the energy comes from France. So, again, is nuclear power good or bad? I don't know, but same thing, Bitcoin is used for illegal things. I guess people have done it. I mean, there are cases with the Silk Road, people buying illegal stuff. The same thing you can say, cash is used for the same reasons. So it's the use that matters, not the technology per se. And also, there's one more thing. Bitcoin has this connotation of being pseudo anonymous, which means that everything you do is registered on this on the blockchain, on this public database. So whatever trace you leave is gonna be like carved into the blockchain forever. So, I mean, if you want to do illegal activity, I'm not really sure it's actually the best thing to do, because whatever you do, you leave like a breadcrumb, you leave a trace that's gonna stay there forever.
Okay.
One quick question. How many users do in the next years are you setting as your goal for Konio?
Well, as many as we can handle with our servers. That's why we want to hear more about KX allows us to scale more.
Getting in 2 years, how many users you hope to have in your...
There are 60 million people in Italy, let's say. 10%, 6 million is going to be already like a wonderful number. I mean, I don't know, to be honest. These things are very hard to predict. Things like catch like wildfire. Like when Facebook arrived, I mean, Facebook started in the United States in 2003. Arrived in Italy around 2008. In a couple of months, like almost like 50% of young people in Italy already had Facebook. So you really, it's very hard to know, like to define numbers when popular things start growing virally. So we hope a lot of million users, but I mean, I cannot really tell.
Okay. If you have anything to add, otherwise we can.
No, that's fine. No. Thank you very much.
Thank you.